suctioning endotracheal and nasooral suctioning presented by سلوى محمد أحمد clinical instructor at faculty of nursing pediatric department. Suctioning is defined as a mechanical aspiration of pulmonary secretions from the child airway passage. Purpose of suctioning is to maintain airway patency by removing pulmonary secretions or foreign matters from the endotracheal tube, improve breath sounds, improve oxygen saturations, heart rate, blood pressure and respiratory rate, decrease work of breathing, improve chest movement, and collect tracheal aspirate for diagnostic purposes. Indications of suctioning including hypoxemia, abnormal breath sound by auscultation or noisy breathing, increased work of breathing, visible secretions in endotracheal tube, and recent history of large amounts of suctioning. Endotracheal suctioning is the first type of suctioning. Endotracheal suctioning is defined as the process of applying negative pressure to the distal endotracheal tube or trachea by introducing a catheter.
Portable or wall suction apparatus, sterile water for irrigation, monitoring equipment as cardiac monitor, which includes oxygen saturation, heart rate, and blood pressure. Personal protective equipment as sterile gloves, mask, gown, goggles. Oxygen source, manual ventilation bag and mask, disposable plastic apron. Use age-appropriate distraction as a toy. Sterile gauze, appropriate size suction catheter. We have a table in the page of 210 in procedure book. This table show the appropriate suction size, appropriate suction catheter size, and the recommended suction pressure for different age of children. We must revise this table in procedure book to perform the appropriate suction procedure. Now we will start our procedure. The first step is hand washing to avoid transmission of infection. Then we must prepare our needed equipment for suction procedure to save time and to test the function of equipment before its use. Wash hand. Then we must perform a comprehensive respiratory assessment, which includes respiratory rate, working of breathing, air entry, chest sound, saturation, visible secretion, child color, to assess the need for suctioning. Turn on the portable or wall suction apparatus. Ensure the correct suction pressure is set, because the high negative suction pressure and deep suctioning may cause complications such as lobe collapse in children. Also, high pressure may damage the respiratory mucosa. Then, personal protective equipment for suctioning to maintain aseptic technique and to perform standard precaution for the prevention of cross infection. Put the child in semi-fowler position, and for infant, we must place folded receiving blanket or roll under the shoulder. Place the head in aimed a midline position to facilitate cuffing and insertion of the catheter during suction procedure. Place the towel or dressing pad on the child's chest to protect the child and to maintain the sterility. Connect suction catheter to tubing of the suction device using aseptic technique to prevent the infection and to maintain sterility. Set up the sterile cup or container and pour sterile water into it. Don't touch the inside of the cup. Check for proper functioning by placing the catheter into the container while holding a gloved finger or thumb over the port of suction to create suction. 2. Ensure equipment function and checks for catheter patency. Disconnect patient from mechanical ventilator to start suctioning from endotracheal tube. Pre-oxygenate the child by increasing FiO2 with 100% on mechanical ventilator for at least 1 minute or manually with bag valve device. 2. Ensure that the child is well oxygenated. Insert catheter into the endotracheal tube until the child cough or a slight obstruction is felt. Then we must withdraw the catheter half milli to prevent the tracheal damage and to perform a correct suction procedure. Apply suction while rotating the catheter between the thumb and forefinger to ensure effectiveness of suction. Apply suction by occluding the on and off port and gently withdrawing the catheter with a twisting motion. Never suction more than 5 seconds, because the prolonged suction may induce complications such as hypoxia. Allow the child to rest and reoxygenate the patient between suction to decrease child distress. Monitor child heart rate, color, and saturation throughout the procedure to allow monitoring throughout the procedure and to prevent the incidence of complication. Web the suction catheter with sterile gauze after withdrawing it to clear out tubing. Clean the catheter by flushing sterile water to clear out the catheter. Repeat steps from 14 to 20 if further suctioning is required to allow effective suctioning. Return the child to previous oxygen setting. Auscultate the chest sound and monitor respiratory rate, respiratory effort, oxygenation, heart rate, color, comfort, and safety to determine the effectiveness of suctioning. Clean and return equipment. Wash hands to reduce transmission of microorganisms. Document the child response to suctioning, the type, consistency, amount of suction secretions, any changes in heart rate and respiratory rate.
The second type of suctioning is nasooral suctioning. Nasooral suctioning is the aspiration and removal of secretions from the airway via the oral, nasal passage and pharynx without a tracheal tube or trachea. Routes for suctioning. Oral route is to remove secretions from the mouth and perform it using a Yankee suction catheter. Oropharyngeal route extends from the lips to the pharynx. Can be performed for children who are breathing spontaneously but unable to maintain an open airway. Oropharyngeal suctioning requires the insertion of a suction catheter through the mouth to the nasopharyngeal route extends from the tip of the nose to the pharynx. The suction catheter is inserted through the nostrils into the pharynx. Airway adjuncts, girdle, can be used if the child is unable to tolerate suction without them or is in an unconscious state.
Nasooral suctioning. Definition: nasooral suctioning. Suctioning is the aspiration and removal of secretions from the airway via the oral nasal passage and pharynx without a tracheal tube or tracheostomy. We have different routes for suctioning of nasooropharyngeal suctioning, such as oral suction, oropharyngeal suction, nasopharyngeal suction. Oral suction to remove the secretions from the mouth and perform it using a Yankee suction catheter. Oropharyngeal from the lips to the pharynx can be performed for children who are breathing spontaneously but are unable to maintain an open airway. Oropharyngeal suctioning requires the insertion of a suction catheter through the mouth to the pharynx. Nasopharyngeal suction from the tip of the nose to pharynx. The suction catheter is inserted through the nostrils to remove the secretion from lips and nose. The equipment used for nasopharyngeal suctioning: portable or wall suction apparatus, sterile water for irrigation, monitoring equipment such as oxygen saturation, heart rate and blood pressure, personal protective equipment as sterile gloves, mask, gown and goggles, oxygen source, manual ventilation bag and mask, disposable plastic apron, use age appropriate distraction, sterile goose, appropriate size suction. We have a table. This table is illustrate the different age and the appropriate catheter size and suction pressure. Procedure: the first step, wash hand to avoid transmission of infection. Prepare all needed equipment to promote efficient time management and to test the function of the needed equipment. Wash hand to avoid transmission of infection. Then we must perform a comprehensive respiratory assessment, which includes respiratory rate, working of breathing, air entry, chest sound, saturation, visible secretion, child color, to assess the need for suctioning. Turn on the portable or wall suction apparatus to provide an organized approach to the procedure. Ensure the correct suction pressure is set, because high negative pressure and deep suctioning may cause a complication such as loop collapse in children, and high pressure also may damage respiratory mucosa. Then, personal protective equipment for suctioning. To maintain the aseptic technique and to perform standard precautions for the prevention of cross infection, place the conscious child in semi-fowler position and place folded receiving blanket or roll under the shoulder of the child. Place head in a midline of the position for the unconscious child. Place the child on lateral position facing the person performing the suction. Because the position facilitates cuffing and insertion of catheter, the lateral position facilitates drainage of secretions and help to prevent aspiration. Place the plastic apron on the child's chest to protect the child from secretions. Connect suction catheter to the tubing of the suction device using aseptic techniques to maintain sterility and to prevent the incidence of infection. Set up the sterile cup or container and pour sterile water into it. Don't touch the inside of cup. The inside of cup is considered be sterile. The water is used to clear the catheter of secretions. For the nasopharyngeal suctioning, we must measure the catheter from nose to air loop to assure the catheter will be inserted to the appropriate depth. Pre-oxygenate the patient by increasing FiO2 with 100% by bag valve for at least 1 minute. Lubricate catheter with a sterile water lubricant before insertion to avoid trauma to the child nose. Hold the child head and insert the catheter into the nose without applying any suction to the measured depth to prevent trauma to the patient's nose. Apply suction by occluding the on and off port and gently withdrawing the catheter with a twisting motion. Suctioning can result in hypoxia. Allow the patient to rest and reoxygenate the child between suction to prevent the incidence of complications such as hypoxia. For oropharyngeal suctioning, apply the steps we demonstrated before. And for oropharyngeal suctioning, determine the depths for catheter insertion. For oral suction, measure from air loop to corner of the mouth to assure the catheter will be inserted to the appropriate depths. Apply suction by occluding on and off port and gently. Suctioning can result in hypoxia. Whip the catheter with sterile gauze after withdrawing it to clear out tubing.